My name is Dr. Matt Lamanna, and I'm an assistant curator in the section of vertebrate paleontology and the head of the section of vertebrate paleontology here at Carnegie Museum of Natural History. And today, we're in the Paleo Lab, the on-exhibit fossil lab here at the museum. A few months ago, several colleagues from Argentina and I published a new dinosaur that belonged to the dinosaur family Megaraptoridae. And you might ask, I've never heard of this dinosaur group before. What are they? Well, the answer is we paleontologists don't know nearly as much about them as we'd like to either. We do know that Megaraptorids were predatory dinosaurs. They were probably the top predators in their environments. They had long, low skulls that were filled with sharp, serrated teeth that they used to cut meat. They had long hind limbs, so they probably were fairly quick moving animals. They may have been covered in something like feathers, what we call proto-feathers, these filament-like structures that we paleontologists think were the predecessors of feathers. But most notably, Megaraptorids had gigantic hands. I'm holding a copy of the thumb claw of a different Megaraptorid that some friends and I found in Argentina back in 1998. And as you can see, this is just the part we have is almost a foot long, but it's not complete. It would have stretched out to about here when the animal was alive and would have been covered in keratin, the same material your fingernails are made of. And so this animal's claw, when this creature was alive walking around Patagonia 95 million years ago, would have stretched almost 18 inches long. So a massive, massive claw, one of the largest claws that we know for any dinosaur. Now, Megaraptorids have a very interesting history. The first Megaraptorid to be discovered was named in 1997, and it was named Megaraptor. So Megaraptor gives its name to the entire family of dinosaurs, the Megaraptorids. The paleontologists that named Megaraptor had only four bones to work with. One of them was a giant claw, and he thought that giant claw went on the foot, and that Megaraptor was a gigantic relative a Velociraptor, made famous by the Jurassic Park movies, which carries a killing claw on the second toe of each foot. So the scientists that named Megaraptor thought it was a giant relative of Velociraptor and gave it the name Megaraptor, giant raptor. Another scientist at a different site in Patagonia found a new specimen of Megaraptor. And this specimen included most of the arm, the forelimb of this animal, with the bones still in life position, still connected as they would have been when the animal was alive. And this specimen revealed, without a doubt, that that claw that it originally thought to have gone on the foot of Megaraptor actually went on the thumb. And raised a whole set of questions as to what Megaraptor and its relatives, the other Megaraptorids, were actually related to. They definitely weren't giant relatives of Velociraptor. They were some other kind of predatory dinosaur, but exactly which kind has not yet been resolved by paleontologists. So they could be relatives of a dinosaur called Allosaurus, which is well known from the Upper Jurassic of North America, or they could even be primitive relatives of Tyrannosaurus rex, in other words, members of the same larger group that includes T-Rex and its close relatives. So the mysteries of Megaraptorids continue, and they will continue to persist until we paleontologists can find new, more complete specimens that tell us much more about the anatomy and the evolutionary relationships of these creatures.